Hello and welcome to video number 6. We're going to talk about deal details, and this will be step number 4. So under step 4, we have deal details. You can change the buy button, the color from yellow, blue, or green. You can change the text from buy now, add to cart, grab it now, get it now, get this deal, or grab it free. So in this case, I'm going to make it yellow and add to cart. Now this buy button affects this buy button here. So when I do the update, this blue button will change to the yellow add to cart button. Then next we have the pay link or JVZoo code. Now we can't do this right now because the way the system is set up, you actually have to fill out all the details first. And then once you save and preview, on the next page after that, you'll get what we call a pay success URL, which you'll then enter into your payment processor's thank you page area. And then you'll be able to get the code or the link. And I'll cover that in the future videos after we do all of this. So just want to keep in mind that we're going to come back to this specific field in the future. But for now, let's move on to deal end URL. Basically, the deal end URL is the URL which will be redirected to if the deal ends. So if the deal has ended, where do you want your visitors to be sent to? There are many, many different avenues that you can take to increase your profits. But if you leave it blank, it'll basically redirect to your deal directory. And then from that point, your visitors can buy your other deals. But if you want to take it to the next level and really monetize this, then here are some suggestions. One other way to use this is to create a duplicate deal, perhaps a countdown quantity or evergreen basis, and perhaps at a higher price, and then link this to the duplicate deal. This way, you can use the initial scarcity, but keep a deal going indefinitely with an ever-increasing price. So, for example, let's say that our deal is $7. When the deal ends, you can send them to a deal-ending URL, which is a duplicate deal, in this case, and then upgrade it from $7 to $17, because you're always going to get people who still want the deal, and if you remove it totally, then they won't be able to get it. But some people are willing to pay just a little more money because they were unable to get it. So that's one way you can increase your profits. Or of course, you could also send them to an opt-in page and gather the leads from that point. So that's what the deal ending URL is all about. Otherwise, you leave it blank, it'll be redirected to your deal directory. Deal pricing is basically just what people see. So if I go here, in this example, we have the deal price, the regular price, and what you save. Now, this part here will be automatically calculated. So the currency, you can choose from US dollars, UK, pounds, euros, Canadian dollars, Australian dollars, and Japanese yen. These possibilities may increase in the future, but as of now, this is what we have. In this case, I'm going to choose US dollars. I'm going to put the deal price at $7 and the regular price at, let's say, $47. Now, let me explain to you what the deal types mean. There are three different types of deals. There's quantity countdown, date and time countdown, and evergreen countdown. Let me start with quantity countdown. If you choose a deal type, you'll notice that it actually changes here. You have quantity left and stop quantity. Now, let me explain the deal quantity in more detail because there's actually two different features within this feature, and I don't want you to get confused. So, Let's say, for example, that you have a physical product and you have 1,000 physical products or digital products, whatever that might be, but you just have a limited amount of 1,000, and then what you want is that when it hits zero, you want the deal to end. If that's the case, then you want to leave the stock quantity zero or blank, either or. Now, let's say, for example, that you have 2,000 or 3,000 or 4,000, but at this time, you only want to offer 1,000 in terms of the total quantity. If you put a number in here, like let's say, for example, 500 or even 50, what will happen is the countdown itself, the number that's counting down, will start at 1,000, it'll go all the way to 50, and then it'll stop. But people can still purchase the deal. So the deal doesn't actually end in this case if you put a stop quantity. It's merely just an illusion or a sneaky way of the countdown. So as you can see, two different avenues that you can take. Date and time countdown just enables you to count down a certain number of days. You can choose the time zone that you want it to end and the deal end. For example, today is Thursday, May 23rd. And let's say, for example, that I want it to be one full week. If I select this, click OK, then it will last for 7 days. And this really gives you the ability to really make it last for a long time if you choose to do so. Now, another cool feature is Evergreen Countdown. Evergreen Countdown is an ongoing deal, so it really never ends. It only ends for that particular user. Now, the cool thing about this is it actually cookies the user. The visitor comes to the site if it's 7 days, and then if they come back to the site later on, let's say 3 days later, they'll see 4 days and so forth and so forth. You could even get it down to minutes. So, in other words, it's going to be different for every user. You might come and it will end. Another customer comes 24 days later, they will see the same amount. So, if you want it to be an evergreen ongoing deal, you can do that. And that's the beauty of this system. So, remember, we got quantity, date and time, and evergreen. And let's say, for example, that I'm going to go with the date and time countdown, and I'm going to set this for 24 hours. Now, the social quantity field here is added to the real number sold and displays on the number of people who bought this deal area of the social bar. Now, let's say, for example, that we put 125. If that's the case, when we activate the deal, when we go to the deal, we'll see that 125 people grabbed the product. So it's kind of like social proof. At this point, anytime somebody purchases the product, it will count from this as the starting point. And then we have tabs. Tabs basically enable you to add content. For example, if I go here, you'll see there's no tabs. But if you go here, you can see that there are three different tabs. Now, you have the ability to add up to 5 different tabs, as you can see here. And to just give you some ideas for the title of tabs, you can have the breakdown, such as a sales letter. You could have reviews. You could have videos. You could have images. Maybe a map to your store. You could have demos, feature lists, benefit lists, and much more. So in this case, let's say, for example, I'm going to do a intro, and then I'll maybe put a few more tabs here. We got an intro, we've got the breakdown, and I have the reviews right here. Now, the cool thing about this feature is if you turn it off and you turn it back on, it'll actually save your data, as you can see here. Now, what I found out is that you can either enter your text here or enter an image or video. What I found is that it's probably actually easier to create a sales page, do a screenshot on that page and create a picture and upload that image. So that way you don't really have to work around the editor. Even though the editor is great, you can do your own formatting and just take a screenshot and upload that image. And that's typically what a lot of people do, is they take a screenshot of their sales letter and simply upload their images here. So as you can see here, this is an example of having text about, having an image about the breakdown and the reviews here. And if you want to learn how to create screenshots for the specific purpose, I'm going to create an additional video that shows you how to do this. And also keep in mind that the EDB system doesn't really replace sales letters, but is generally used for specific deals for your products and things like that. So just bear that in mind. Now I want to walk you through quickly on how to use the editor. And then you can basically turn this into a paragraph, quote, header, 1, 2, 3, 4. You can bold it, you can italicize it, you can delete it or put a strike through it. You can underline it, you can create unordered lists or order lists. You can indent and outdent. You can insert an image, insert a video, create a link, change the font color, change the back color for highlighting, the alignment, and insert a horizontal line. Now, in this case, I went ahead and took a screenshot, so I'm going to do insert image, and I'm going to go ahead and choose the file and there we go. Now, if you want to center align it or left align it or right align the image, all you have to do is select the image and you will actually be given the ability to give it a title, give it a link if you want to hyperlink the image, or position it from center, left, or right. So we're going to center the image. We're going to click on save and there we go. And then breakdown, I'm going to do the same thing. And of course you can enter a link here, or you can drag and drop the file here, or do this. So as you can see here, we have kind of the intro, the breakdown, and the reviews. And that's it. Now you can see if I go back to this page and I've updated it, we've got the deal price, the regular price, the percentage saved, which is automatically calculated. We've changed the button to the yellow add to cart. We've added the tabs here for the intro, the breakdown of the video course, and the reviews. So as you can see, very, very easy to do. Now in the next video, I'm going to show you how to create and edit the thank you page settings.